Hello students, today we will start with the comparison between metallic conduction and electrolytic conduction. See, conduction of electricity through metals and through electrolytes. Okay, metals, they are solid, and when the flow of electricity takes place in solid, it takes place by the flow of electrons, which have negligible mass. Okay, electrons, they have negligible mass. That's why while calculating out the mass number of an atom, we do not consider the mass of electrons. This we know. Okay, and in metals, flow of electrons, due to the flow of electrons, flow of electricity takes place. Now if you talk about electrolyte means aqueous solution or molten state of any salt. There the flow of electricity takes place by the flow of ions, which are denser as compared to electrons. These ions, they are denser as compared to electrons. Okay, now see the second point. There is no decomposition of parent metal, and thus the chemical properties of metal are intact. There is no change in the chemical properties of metals. The parent metal remain as such. Only the electrons, they flow through the wire, but the parent metal, it remains as such. But if you talk about the electrolyte, there is the decomposition of electrolytic solution. They decompose into their cations and anions. Yes, and then oxidation and reduction takes place at different electrodes. Metals are good conductors of electricity in the solid state and in molten state. Metals, they conduct electricity. Electrolytes are good conductors of electricity in aqueous solution or molten state, not in solid, no solid state, because if they will remain in their solid state, no dissociation into ions will take place and no conduction of electricity will take place. Okay, now during metallic conduction, there is no transfer of matter. Matter do not transfer from any place, it remains there only, but here transfer of ions, it takes place. The flow of electricity only produces heat energy and no new products are formed. Here the flow of electricity decomposes the electrolyte and new products are formed. Yes, so here they have done the comparison between copper metal and copper sulfate solution. Okay, here if you talk about copper metal, it is a good conductor of electricity. We all know that all the wires which are there in our house or wiring, it is of copper metal only, which is insulated with PVC, and this is a good conductor of electricity, but is a non-electrolyte, means it will not decompose into or dissociate into its ions. It cannot, since it does not undergo any chemical decomposition due to the flow of electric current through it. When electric current passes through it, it does not undergo any chemical decomposition. On the other hand, if we talk about copper sulfate, it is an electrolyte and it decomposes on passage of electric current. When electric current is passed through it, it decomposes to form copper ions and sulfate ions, and copper ions, they are discharged at cathode. Copper ions will move towards the negative electrode, that is cathode, and they will collect as copper metal there when copper electrodes are used during electrolysis. So these are discharged at cathode. Okay, now see voltammeter, construction of voltammeter is there, and here we have to identify whether the given compound or given aqueous solution, it is a strong electrolyte or a weak electrolyte. So here is an arrangement where this is electrolytic tank. Here electrolyte is filled, and these are the two electrodes. The one which is connected to the positive terminal, it is anode, and the one which is connected to the negative terminal, it is cathode. N negative, C P positive, A P A N C. Okay. So we have to determine whether the given compound, A, that is acid or base or salt, whatever it is a strong electrolyte or a weak electrolyte. See, bulb is here. Main role of bulb it will play here in this experiment. Apparatus, two are there. X is the electrolytic solution, which is here, and Y are the electrodes. These are the electrodes. Procedure, a given compound A, whatever it is, acid, base or salt, it is in its fused or aqueous solution. It is placed in this electrolytic tank. Electrolytic cell will place that solution and will switch on this. What we'll see, what we'll observe, the conduction of electricity through the electrolyte is indicated by the glow of the bulb. If this bulb will glow very brightly, it means the electrolyte is strong. If the bulb will glow very dim, it means the electrolyte is weak electrolyte. Okay, so by this experiment we can identify whether the compound which is given to us, it is a strong electrolyte or a weak electrolyte. Thank you, and tomorrow we'll study more about the electrolytes, and we'll differentiate acids, bases and salts according to the conduction of electricity. Thank you.